Welcome guys, welcome to unixtech.in. So I think you are doing well. So today topic is Samba server, how we can access Samba server without entering any username password. Yesterday we learned about Samba server, how we can install Samba server in Ubuntu easily without facing any error. But that topic about to access the Samba server with username password. But today topic is about to access the Samba server without entering any username password. So let's start. We will access the Samba server in Windows with the help of Windows Ubuntu system. First we will install Samba in Ubuntu, then we will show you how we can access in Windows system. So let's start. So this is my PPT, as you can see. So here Samba server's configuration is already installed in my PC. But you can install directly by putting this command. You will not face any error. So go to this command and put here. If there will be any error, we'll let you know and we'll guide you for the troubleshooting. But you will not face any error here because everything is installed. You can see newest version is already available. Like yesterday we have installed. You can install with the help of same command. So you will not face any error here. Now let me copy this Samba config file. I am copying this Samba config to etc Samba and Samba config file to this folder. And let's see. So this is done. And next is now proceed for next. Okay, and no need to run this command. This is for window. If you want to run in a window, you can run with window. Let me create one directory, unmonitored directory. Okay, yesterday we created directory in desktop. This directory you can see we have already here scanned folder, but here we will create another directory. Anonymous shared means the user which work without any accessing of username password. So directory is created into the Samba folder. Now go to this, provide the permission to this Samba folder. So here I'm adding a permission to Samba folder, permission added. So next will be hold on guys, let me close it remote. So next command is, let me give permission to anonymous share folder. Nobody group means appropriate permission directory that we can access without any authentication, without any username password. So let's start and give permission to this folder, anonymous directory folder, and we are ready. And next command will be, sudo vi samba config. Here I will use nano because nano is my favorite tool. Editing is, there are three type of editing, nano, vi and gedit. You can use anyone. If you are having good knowledge of nano or gedit, you can use gedit. Here I'm using nano, so depend on you. So nano is also a good tool to use this future or to edit this our config file. So here let me show you to change in a policy or file, network file. Everything is already done guys. Before starting this video, I will guide you to watch previous video first, because previous video you will come to know about the basic of Samba, how Samba work, how you can create the manual folder for Samba, how you can share with other to access other users. So this is the second video of our Samba, so which you will access with the help of any username password. So here let me check and provide the required permissions. As you can see in our PPT also, next edit and modify the directories. Here I want to add this directory. If already available, you can edit over there. Let me check if available or not. Anonymous, hold on, printers. Anonymous profile is not available. So what I will do here, I will go to this and in end of the file I will paste this all file. As you can see, Samba in Samba folder number share is there. So path should be valid before giving path. It's just check, it should be valid. Okay, so hold on guys, one mistake I have done here. Let me put okay, so anonymous, let me put the directory username to our folder. Now you can see SRV sub Samba anonymous. So in Samba our folder is there, so path should be correct. And force user nobody means force user, it will not ask for your username password. So browsable should be yes, writable should be yes, guest should be okay, yes, and read should be no. So and one more thing, I will guide you here. See network network interface should be like this. Okay, so as I have already guided you in previous video, please watch my previous video before clearing this concept. So request you to go through our previous Samba video, then you will come to know the complete step. So this is also a second method. So while following this method, you will also not face any issue. So here for nano I will put control X, and for making changes successfully, put Y and press yes, enter. So next will be to test the following dependencies running successfully or not. Let me run this command to verify the configuration. So here we will get the okay. So as you can see, net was too long, 15 gonna roll, no print, press enter, sheet, dump your server. Okay, so as you can see, I have created this settings and in our Samba config file, and we have successfully installed it. And next will be let's start for next command. And you can see same this PPT have followed, and whatever in PPT shown, everything we have followed as a correct manner. There will not be any issue. So now let's start the Samba services while entering this command. Go to this command. So hold on guys, let me copy it properly. So copy this command and put in folder and put enter. Our Samba service will be enabled, so wait for a while. So now if you are facing any error in the Samba services, you can use second command to restart the Samba services. So let me put the second command here, wait for a minute. You can see our services are enabled without getting any error. Second command, you can also run this this command. This will also enable services. If first command you are getting any errors, you can use second command. So now let me check our services are working or not. So here how we will check, check your username, your IP address first, and put this IP address in your Ubuntu PC. Go to your Ubuntu PC, hold on guys. So here our Windows PC, go to Windows plus R, run, and put your IP here and go to put enter. Here you can see anonymous folder is available. Let me check this is working without password or not. So as you can see, nothing in here. He didn't ask me for you entering username password. That means your Samba service is working well and you are not facing any issue. You are able to access the anonymous folder without entering any username password. So this is the way how you can create the Samba server and how you can install in your PC. So while Ubuntu, I can access now our anonymous folder without entering their username password. So this way you can use your services. Let me show you where is the folder. Samba folder is in computer, and go to sub, and here you can see Samba. Here you have one username. I have created four folder, and you can see four folders are already available. So whatever you want to share, you want to share your data, you want to share your important files, you want to copy any software, whatever you want to copy here, you can do without facing any challenges. So this is the method how you can work with the anonymous folder without entering username password. So if I'm put wait, okay, hold on guys, So you can see I have copied the files here in our anonymous folder, and we can easily it is easily taking the means copy pasting the file here. Let me delete all file and copy again. As you can see, files are copied here. If you want to copy any other file, you can copy with this method. Like I'm copying this my world file. If you want to world, go to this directory and paste it. You can see files are easy copy paste, and if you want to view in your files anonymous folder, as you can see files are able to visible and without facing any error. So this was the method how you can work with the Samba folder. And previous I have already guided you how you can create a Samba folder with username password with security purpose. You can use that method, and for this method anonymous method without entering any username password is Samba is working fine. So this PPT I will share you in my YouTube description. You will get this PPT, you can download over there and you can start your project. So this is for today's, and thank you so much guys for your subscribing, for your loving. Please subscribe my channels and share with your friends. And next video I will taught you about the other applications like FTP and more other applications, Apache, and there is a multiple application like Apache and other application tools. I will guide you again next coming video. So keep watching guys, subscribe my channel, share with your friends. So thank you so much and Jai Hind.